I'll meet you by the elevator.
I saw them. Over here. Are you ready? He's waiting for us. I just watched some of your footage from this week. It's amazing. Blackbird was mental. And we all got so excited that we started talking about this idea for a trailer about him. Maybe start with him drinking, talking to some pirates, telling a story. Then we cut to him leaping across the deck of his boat and, sorry, his ship, not boat, but jumping around the deck of his ship, swinging from ropes and fighting like a devil. I mean, obviously, we're going to have to manipulate some of the existing footage to get it looking good, but it could be great. I'm getting a shiver in the timbers just thinking about it. Sorry. Bonjour, ça va? I hope we're not late.
No, you can go right.
Hi, Melania. So you just walked in. I need a few minutes with you alone. Leticia is on the phone and we're discussing the Kenway project.
Oh, yes, of course. Sorry about this. I'll call you when we're ready.
Shouldn't be long.
Hello? Hello? Do you have a second?
Of course you do.
Head to the waypoint on your map. I have another job for you. I'd like to link all the cameras in the building to a central monitoring system, but most aren't calibrated correctly. Another locked door. Not a problem. Voila. You now have level 2 security clearance. Not bad for your first few weeks. Find solid state your communicator.
Rest assured, we have our best employee working on this, but it will take time.
That means you.
Focus on the observatory.
Assassins, Templars, crazy talk. I'm curious about this shareholders meeting, though. How about you break into Olivier's office and see if you can find his schedule? Oh, what? You don't like that idea? Well, how about I blow the fucking whistle on you, hacker? I own you. I say? Now, step over to the window. Kent waltzed into Olivier's office through the front door, so I've opened another route. Up we go. Did you know that Abstergo was run by Templars? Oh, yeah. Sounds like crackpot stuff, I know. But then again, the moon landing was safe, right? So, it's possible. All right. Either you walk through that door, or throw yourself off the terrace. Those are your options. Oh, well done, kiddo. Find his computer. Make it snappy. We're looking for the
shit. Oh, I pressed forward too many times. No. I hate that glitch. Thank you.
through and through, ain't you? Now, get down to the lobby. There's a courier waiting. Yeah, that's right. I've been planning this for a few hours. Now, wait. The receptionist. Hold on. I'll try something. As gullible as ever. Now, hurry down to the lobby before I remotely detonate your earpiece.
Yeah. Shit. Bethesda. Okay. Wolfenstein, yeah. So I'm playing the present day portion of this game, and then I hacked the computer that gave like emails for various locations that they're looking at, because you know I'm technically a worker at Abstergo who's, you know, working there or whatever, and it listed several locations for the next couple of games, like, that they're looking at, and all of them have been true except for the last one, so I think that's where the next one's gonna be. So they did, it says Jack the Ripper in Victorian London, which was Syndicate, it just came out. Hold on, wait, let me find it. Yeah, okay, so Jack the Ripper in Victorian London, Napoleon Bonaparte in the French Revolution, which is Unity, and then the last one they said is Billy the Kid and Wyatt Earp in the Wild American West. Yeah, the Wild West. And then there's Genghis Khan and the Mongols Kid, and the Mongols. I don't think they would go backwards, like, in time. I'm like, the Wild West would be interesting, but I think I would like them. I would like to see them do, what's it called first? Civil War, I think would be a nice one. Because you don't have as much vehicles as you do with, you know, like, later on times. Thank you. Shit, I did not want to go that way. What? What are you trying to get it for? Ooh, that's tough actually. I don't even know how you would, well, I guess I would say to go into Damo and try to do it that way and just shoot it into people trying to capture. That one was pretty tough. First one's easy. Because the recoil kind of goes up.
Our researchers looked into the life of Altair Ibn Lahed, hoping to find a biography that might serve as a positive role model for Abstergo's global outreach programs. Unfortunately, this renegade assassin proved to be no such thing. In much of his footage, we see a man gleefully flouting some of his culture's most entrenched taboos with an arrogance that borders on messianic.
Altair! No! This is not our way! To burn a man's body is forbidden!
Many of our researchers felt that the arguments articulated by Altair's rival, a man known as Abbas, were clearer and more cogent than any we heard from Altair. I recently put in a request that more effort be dedicated to locating one of Abbas's descendants, if any exist. It's clear to us that Altair's transgressions were the primary motivation behind the ultimate dissolution of his despicable order by the middle of the 13th century. We therefore strongly recommend a pass on this property in favor of a more agreeable and inspiring figure from this era.
You guys leave tomorrow, right? times you guys fight? That's not bad. Ha! Bloom. CTOS. This is from Watch Dogs. Nice little Easter egg.
the lobby. Now.
Shut up, don't tell me what to do. Good or bad?
You're out getting some food. Me? Well, I'm supposed to be getting ready to break into some offices in the financial district. Feels just like prepping for one of your old training drills, actually.
At least it's something different, you know? One more computer in here. Thank you. Guess that's how the computers.
Where the hell are you going? Get down to the lobby.
Oh, shush. Going right now. Fuck, I gotta work at 8 tomorrow. Let's go sleep early. 8 to 4:30. Yeah. I'm so not used to fucking walking that much. Nah, I'm really tired. It's just my legs are sore, like yesterday. It's just a bloody coffee.
Oh, hooray! It's our old friend.
Plus, I don't think I had the right shoes either.
Picking up another transfer.
Oh, you said you were here to see
me. I was using running shoes, and I'm like, it's probably not the best to use.
Let's see it. A conference in Chicago. Very nice. Thanks for this. We'll be in touch.
Ciao, Rebecca. Text me.
Stuff it, Hastings.
Apologies for my temper tantrum there. You are with the good guys, I promise. We'll keep you safe. Trust me. Go on back to work. We'll be in touch.
Badass elevator. And I'm back. I just went to the bathroom and grabbed some cookies.
I've an awful feeling about this. You'll be hurt out there. I couldn't handle that.
I'll be careful, I promise. And when I'm flush with coin and set up, I'll send for you. I will.
I can't promise I'll come, Edward. If you leave on this fool's errand, I cannot promise anything.
Don't give up on me, Caroline. Not when I need your faith the most.
Putting some shape to your sentiments?
Just a short letter home. I reckon she's past caring anyway.
Oh, your hard haircut should be softer.
Or soft in parts that should be hard.
And how is it you're so keen for his hard parts, Mr. Ruffin?
You'd like to wear my secrets, would you?
Oh, aye. Give me a small hint, like. Or a large one if you're an upright gentleman.
Open your hand.
Oh!
Who's shooting?
Might be them six sliding into port.
Jesus.
We demand a parley.
Well, I'll be hanged. Little George has grown tired of our shenanigans.
Who's the grim fella?
That's Captain Woods Rogers. Not a man I want seeing my face.
We desire a parley with the men who call themselves governors of this island. Charles Vane, Ben Hornigold, and Ed Thatch. Come forth, if you please.
Hear about the king's pardon, I reckon.
What the hell is Hornigold doing?
Lily living punk!
What are you men up to?
I am grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception...
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put. This affair is shaped than I expected to see from any pirate. But I promise fair treatment to all who hear me out.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers.
I have given Captain Hornigold my word that he will be equitable.
Won't do you a little good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer afflicting the new world. The King wants them eradicated above all else.
Is this the town square?
As close to one as we've ever had.
Incredible. It's no cleaner than a dock's kennel. Captain Hornigold, please call your men.
Rackham, Vane, the governor's come calling. Bring Burgess and Corcoran as well.
Man out, lads, and take this shanty town as if it were your own.
I have my message, Commodore, and I expect you to honor them to the letter. A lot of you. Make way for the King's emissaries.
Out of the way, you bastard!
I'll be in here and merchant, masons, and carpenters are rounded up and brought to me this afternoon. We must see about repairing this fortress.
He should be confiscating weapons, Governor. Send these pirates a clear, strong message that the King's emissaries are not to be trifled with.
I have no wish to stir up animosity here, Commodore. And though well armed, we are outnumbered by a decent margin. Slow persuasion is our best and most efficient weapon.
Portal, Governor!
Every goddamn ship not flag the King's colors.
Aye, sir. Your wishes are clear as crystal.
These are the sharks, Commodore. We're in position.
Governor Rogers believes he can make men of these monkeys yet. I do not. Return to your post and await my orders.
How's the combat in that game? Is it decent? It's FPS, right? Kill guards while hanging from a ledge. And of course, starts to rain. Sounds like one of those games you could like beat in a weekend.
I pray you take the prudent course, gentlemen, and accept the king's pardon as soon as your hearts allow. For until such time, all of you will be confined in the cell. I am sorry for this, but in lieu of a public trial, this pardon is your best bet.
The governor puts it far too brightly, maggots. Take this message home. Accept the king's protection forthwith, or we will raise this town to its foundation and stretch your bloody necks.
Heath! Commodore Chamberlain, we are messengers, not executioners. Not yet.
Oh, thank you, sir. God save you.
Look on this as a stroke of fortune, lads. We should take the king's pardon and salvage what dignity we own.
Yes. I'll be hanged before I surrender to that bobby.
Check your head, Vane. We had here a rare opportunity, a chance to take something base and shape it into a government made and maintained by men of vision. But in 2 years, we pissed it away. I won't make that mistake again.
It's truth is telling, and you whelps can't handle it. But you, you forecastle-headed fuddlers, see you at the gallows.
You'll all be dead then! Bastards! I need a drink.
That mission was somewhat easy. It wasn't as hard as I thought it was going to be. I'll give it a 3. Oh great, I just spawned in a fucking... no... whatever. In a red zone. Oh, and I can't fast travel either? That's just dumb. I guess I shall have to make my escape. And I'm gone. That save was easy. Now I should be able to fast travel. No, I still can't fast travel, really? Maybe it's because I'm wanted. Cool. All of a sudden I can't fast travel anymore. Buy some sleep darts. The story in that game is really good.
Times I've put up with horn gold and his self-righteous shine.
Verily, you are a man of principle, Captain Hornigold. A man I believe I can trust with my best ideas.
Faith, and we'll survive this, Charles, with our pride intact.
That's confidence. You brewed a plan I might get a taste of.
Nassau is over, that's plain to see. I say we skip out tonight and regroup at my compound.
Fair enough. What's your angle?
The Brits have brought their supplies ashore, see? If we nick some gunpowder and pine pitch, we can build a fire ship and send it straight at the blockade, blasting it to smithereens.
Aye. We'll use Rackham's ship. And the capable captain.
My conscience is clear.
Right. You've got the gunpowder. I'll secure the pine pitch.
Steal 4 gunpowder kegs. Alright. Kill 4 guards and 1 kill streak. Alright, I got my 4 kill streak. Now I just need to use the pirate darts on 6 more people. And I complete my optional objective. It's like you don't even know what's going on. There's no like journal or something you can tell you your goal. Go forth, soldier, and kill people for me. I like using these berserker darts because, like, they make the enemies, like, attack themselves. Or, I mean, like, other enemies. Yeah. And then they die right afterwards. Alright, just steal two more powder kegs. How did you randomly see me up here? That's so fucking gay. And now you don't know where I am, even though I'm on a fucking platform. Oh, never mind, you're coming ladder. He's over there. Just die, bro. Just die. Survive this. Yeah, probably. Should have interrupted me when I was trying to steal this barrel. Cause now you're dead. Get the warehouse. That sucks. Like, your teammate didn't catch you or something? How does that even happen? Uh-oh. refill my darts again. Maybe I won't need them. We'll find out. I have a bunch of sleep darts anyways. Should be enough.
Come on, boys, you're lagging.
It's this bloody hand.
Lieutenant. Aye, sir. The Commodore fears a revolt is nigh. His orders are to sink every goddamn pirate ship now anchored in that harbor, tonight.
It's by the governor's wishes, sir.
This is a direct order, soldier. You will take position on the grounded galleon and await the Commodore's further orders. Is that clear?
Aye, sir.
Bastard. Someone ought to slit the Commodore's throat before he gets a chance to bark those orders.
You think so?
Dead in the water, otherwise.
All right, I'll kill him.
Your prayers are baked. I won't take no part in killing the Commodore. Not one of the King's men.
Yeah.
Them to us.
Bush, man. You know what the governor's ire brought down on you? It's a mysterious soul.
Well, I'm much more afraid of the Commodore, in truth. He's a serious chap. No sense of humor.
Air assassinate this guy, eh? Okay, I'll go this way. Is there a rope across? Yes, there is. Now I'm trying to find a way across this ship. I gotta air assassinate this guy, but I'm trying to get to a spot where I can actually do that. Gotcha.
Given us a pardon, Commodore. Don't a man's word mean anything in these times?
Has syphilis clouded your mind? Why scratch and claw to protect such squalor? Your parasites feeding off the industry of honest men.
Much like King George in that respect.
Know your place, peasant. You may have taken my life, but you have not improved your own by any measure.
Does some purpose keep you talking?
If not for that heathen, Governor Rogers, I'd have seen you hanged from your own cross trees. Worm. All of you.
Where's this next mission? Still can't fast travel? Yeah. They literally ran all the way across the map.
Thank you.
Commodore's dead. Are we ready?
We're close. We've got a problem with the galleon. There's a couple of dozen. Bloody hell. You'd raise a cloud here, lout. You sat on enough gunpowder to blow New Providence off its rocks.
Lay off, men, mate. I'm well chafed.
As I was telling, a squad of lobsters is commandeered our galleon. We're going to have to clear it out before we use them cannons to blow the blockade.
Stay near the fire ship, Captain. Keep it afloat.
Huh! Gallants! Royals! Stand!
Who's up for Royals?
Use mortars to sink three ships and barrels to sink another. Alright.
The Brits are on to us. Look there!
Oh shit. Fuck, these fire barrels are hard to use, man. It's like, you drop them off behind your boat and you gotta sink somebody with them. So you have to have somebody chasing you, but they don't chase you, they like run away from you. Like, we have to race in front of a boat and then fucking, like, drop it afterwards. I sank my ally with my barrels. I hate escort missions, but I hate escort missions when I'm escorting a ship. It's even worse.
The Brits are on to us. Look there!
Fire!
Down, Pinhead Green!
That's where the most gender! Ready to fire, Captain! Fire! Left themselves exposed! Make him pay, Captain!
Reach the top, man! Gather!
Fire!
Damn these
eyes! Fire! We're going to hit them!
Foresail! All sail!
All sail! Grab us all!
Shorten sail! Get off the squall! Incoming fire!
Left and bringing those...
Get them to planks!
She fires many bullets!
Douse all sail!
Oh my god, how's my ally dead? Did I mortar my own? Fuck! I did the barrel challenge, but then I mortared my own ally. That's fantastic. Ah. I will do this.
Stay near the fire ship, Captain. Keep it afloat. Ride the wind for all she's worth. Brits are on to us. Look there.
Beat the quarters.
Back to Fallout.
Get up there, sir. That'll wipe them out. On your mark, come out. Fire. Look, Captain. Put a shot right through there.
No, back. Brace yourselves for collision.
Ready. Fire, sir.
Exposed, take
the
socks off!
They're all lying to hell!
Don't let them sink our fire ship. That's our ace.
Ease off the wind!
Slab, sir!
Found the mizzen top!
Drifting around!
Like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do right now. I'm supposed to be escorting the ship, but I don't know where.
All sail! She'll take it!
Loose topsails, gallants and royal!
Oh, there we go. Oh fuck, I'm so far away. Escape the blockade. Alright.
They're firing mortars!
Get starboard! Shipwreck Jack Ahoy! Still alive, Captain!
No pressure, eh, Kenley? The Ubia comes natural to us.
We ain't on this yet.
Of course the ship has to be in a storm, because why not?
Mess there.
Burn you bastards! Yeah! The burning of your ass, governor!
Prancing about like they took a prize.
And he is back. I don't think so. How long is he gone for? My mommy's there. She's because she's had that email for like 15, 16 years. I wouldn't use it as an ISP though. Like, I wouldn't use it as a internet provider.
Oh, hi, kid. You missed quite a time.
Aye. Pity about Nassau and Blackbeard flying the coop.
Well, we'll see about Thatch. Vane's off to see him now, and I'll follow him soon.
This is what's left of your experiment in democracy.
Aye. We do as we please here, and we take our time doing it.
For Christ's sake, Edward. Don't anything but the stink of riches wrinkle your nose.
What's got into you, man?
Reality, mate. Reality. See that you ain't pulled into the drink by this drowning rat.
Aye. I've lived longer than most men who trod this path.